Hey, what's good, y'all? This is Nunu, and welcome to One on One with your boy Nunu. First of all, y'all, let me say this. I never thought that I was sitting in front of the camera and tell the world how I came out. Because being younger, you know, I thought being gay was a bad, horrible thing. And I was praying that night, oh, please help me, Father, in the name of Jesus, I don't want to be gay. But you know what, I came to realize that I'm happy with myself, I'm happy with my life. If God loves me, my family loves me, if my mama love me, if my daddy love me, I don't have no problem. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. I don't care what nobody say. It's like, all that shit don't even bother me because I'm really comfortable with my sexuality that I'm able to, you know, to be a really handsome black gay man in America to sit down in front of you to give you guys my story. I have 6 sisters, 1 brother, and the reason why I told you that, because I don't think anyone knows this about me. I have 2 gay sisters in my family. 2 studs. Really beautiful sisters. All of them beautiful. But these 2 sisters right here is probably the 2 sisters that I'm closest with because I think they understand me more than my other sisters. And I think they know where I'm coming from. They understand the struggle. They understand my situation. They defend me when I have open family discussions, and I think that's a good thing. First of all, let me start, before I give my coming out story to my whole family, I'm gonna give you my first coming out story to my sister, which is L Boogie. She's the first person I ever came out with. Instead of telling you that story, let me show you an interview that I've done with my sister L Boogie back like a year ago. Check this out.
My sister L, of all wonderful 5 sisters, right? How many sisters I got?
You got
5. I got 5 sisters. We've been growing up together and we have this kind of similar same experience of coming out to our parents. We got the same daddy and mother, of course. And tell them how you came out to me. Do you remember?
Well, I came out to you. I remember asking you, I was like, listen, are you gay? Because I'm gay. And then he was like, yeah, I'm gay. We was like, oh, this guy, he was just so extra happy.
We was all our way to school, on the yellow bus.
Yeah.
And it was crazy.
And that's actually when we got a little bit closer, because we never really got
okay. That was my first coming out story to my sister, L Boogie. Let me tell you my coming out story to my family. It was really important to me to get the support from my family because they are the backbone. When your blood is thicker than water. You know what I'm saying? If I don't have their support, who supports I'm gonna have? You know, all the friends and girlfriends and boyfriends will go along, but family will always be there. You know what I'm saying? And they're the one have to be there to support me. You know, if we need something from the inside instead of people from the outside looking in, we need somebody from the inside looking out. You know, so I was visiting New Orleans, Louisiana, from Tulsa, Oklahoma, and I think it was some kind of holiday. I think it was Thanksgiving. And a whole family was there. And one of my sisters, I think Alicia, Lily, she told me that she's gonna come out to the family. My other stud sister. And she said that you need to come out too. That's why I always tell you guys, come out when you are ready, come out when you want to. Because when people pressure you to come out, when they're not ready to come out, it's not cool. Because she wanted me to come out to the family because she's coming out. And I told her, I was like, no. If you want to come out, you can do that. But I'm not ready. And she was upset. But I really sometimes I don't understand my family sometimes. Some people in my family, we all don't get along with our family at times, and we all just like confused, like, why the fuck did she just say that? But at that time, we was arguing. I was like, no, I'm not coming out. If I want to be private when I want to, I can. Because I was dealing with a lot of shit. I was bisexual at the time. And I was really not comfortable of, you know, my family at that time, because they already was asking me. And they already was telling me why this, why that. You shouldn't be gay. I know you ain't gay. And they were trying to hook me up with girls and stuff like that. So I was like, you know what? I'm not nerdy. I'm waiting until I graduate from high school, go to college, and, you know, be ready. That's why I say, if you guys want to wait till you're 28, 25, when you got your career together, like Don Lemon already came off to his family, but to the world, he had to wait till he was ready, till he was at the career point that he was at. You got to figure your way to the top at some times. And I think that's okay. But make sure they know that you do things right. You know what I'm talking about. But She all of a sudden, I told her no. To make a long story short, she told everyone I was gay. I know that's not a typical way that people come out. Sometimes when people come out, it's probably on a mistake. Why, when the mothers read a letter, or the mothers listen to a phone call, the mothers da da da. But your mothers should know if you're gay or not. But my mom always knew that I was gay, but I think that she wasn't ashamed, but she did not want me to be gay. So me and my sister, we just had an argument. We went back and forth, motherfucker, bitch, hoes, blah, 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 blah. Why you did that? And all of a sudden, my mama got upset, and it was a whole full of bullshit that I wasn't ready and prepared for. So my grandfather, may he rest in peace, he came to me. He sat me down. And this is the emotional part about this, because my grandfather sat me down. He said, "What? Are you gay?" And I was like, "I don't know." And then he told me, "Lester." I think he said Nunu, but he said, "Lester, if you're gay, or if you're not gay, I still love you, and I will accept you for who you are." At that point in time, I didn't give a fuck what my mama said, even my daddy said, but my grandfather, because it's a stereotype about older black men in general. They're from another generation, and they don't understand the lifestyle that I live. So for him to tell me out of love that he loved me and he would accept me for who I am, that pushed me to be comfortable for who I am and just to live strong. And I thank him, my grandfather. I dedicate this video to him and my whole career to him, because he told me that he loves me. He's the first person that ever accepted me for who I was. Later down the line, my family started to, my sisters and my little brother always did. My little brother always supported me. My mom, my dad, just recently told me he still don't like my, he don't still love my lifestyle, but he's a pastor. My dad's a pastor, but he still loves me. And that's what people gotta understand. If you're not ready to come out, you guys, don't come out. Don't let people pressure you to come out. But if that time comes, and when it does come, love yourself first, then everything else will fall in place. That's all I gotta say. This has been my coming out story. Thank you for watching One-on-One with your boy Nunu. Make sure you visit yourboynunu.com. That's all I gotta say. Bye.
Comment and subscribe. For bios, pictures, and other shows with Nunu, visit yourboynunu.com.